do we hear a lot about high-risk groups? Who comes under this category, and what should be done to ensure the safety of high-risk groups?
The safety of the people who are more vulnerable, it's very important for COVID-19 management. We know that COVID doesn't have any symptoms or very mild symptoms in 80% of the people. 20% only are affected and they only have symptoms. But even among that, if you look at the severe disease comes out in people who are having some vulnerabilities. The most important factors for this are age. If you are above 60, you are a vulnerable group. And other chronic illnesses like cardiac problem, like somebody who has already suffered a heart attack and who is having an issue due to that, or people with diabetes, people with chronic lung diseases where there is a respiratory issue, they also are at higher risk, like bronchial asthma or people with chronic obstructive airway disease. These are diseases which will predispose you for more of complications during COVID period. And then also people who are immunosuppressed. Suppose you are having an illness where there is a medicine which is being given, which reduces your immunity. This happens in many times in people who have transplantation. For such people, immunosuppressants are given. And in certain diseases also, immunosuppressants are given. And another set of people who are in high risk are the people who have cancer. People with cancer again have high risk of such illnesses happening to them. So old people, as well as people with many of these chronic diseases and the diseases which I mentioned now, they should be extremely careful. And what should be done? We have to be very, very careful for the protection of such people. One is to provide them protection in their homes where they are, instead of taking them to hospital. The visit to hospitals and keeping them or even bringing them in touch with the hospital should be reduced as much as possible. They have to be kept at home. And this is actually called reverse quarantining. This term reverse quarantining, which you hear, is when you keep people who are healthy under protection and isolate them. The usual quarantine happens to somebody who is already ill, who has to be kept in a particular place. And that is what we hear, the usual isolation or quarantine. But here you are protecting people who are not having any illness, but you are as a precaution keeping them safe. And that is called reverse quarantining. And this should happen at homes. There may be limitations for this because many of the homes, if it is especially congested and there are large number of people living there, there may be some limitations for quarantining such people. But as much as possible, try to avoid the contact of such people with outsiders. Don't allow visitors to come in. Very, very important. That will help a lot to avoid their getting infected. And even your own family members, you should ask them not to visit, and especially children. The usual tendency is for children to mingle with their grandparents. So this is a very risky thing because children, because they are young, they will be quite capable of having the virus but not having any symptoms. So such children coming and meeting with an immunocompromised older person will definitely spread this illness to the grandparent or the older person. So please see that children are not intermingling with their grandparents and they are kept away as much as possible. And at the same time, you also have to make sure that it should be a physical distancing. The people shouldn't feel that they are kept aloof and they are not having the access to the whole world. So how do you do that? Even at home, you should have certain activities in which the older people are involved. Like maybe it is even the rearranging the albums. And there are a lot of things which can be done during this period. Most importantly, the virtual can be utilized by giving them access, or if they don't know, teaching them how they can use the virtual media where they can speak with their relatives and people outside and feel connected. So please take care of that. Avoid physical distancing, but don't do psychological distancing. try to keep them involved in all activities. This is what we have to be careful in older people as well as in people with other debilitating illnesses.
Thank you for that insight, sir. Well, today we've received some valuable advice by Doctor with regards to older people, pregnant women, and other high-risk groups. Let us all keep them protected and safe and fight this out through. Once again, Dr. Moopen, thank you very much for your time.